हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अवर कंटिन्यू टॉपिक अबाउट द न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशंस रिएक्शंस। सो सिंस फ्रॉम लास्ट टू और थ्री सेशंस, एज वी नो दैट इन द केस ऑफ हेलोअल्केन एंड हेलोएरिन कंपाउंड्स मोस्टली गिव्स अ थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शंस रिगार्डिंग टू योर टेक्स्ट बुक। फर्स्ट इज द रिएक्शंस व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशंस रिएक्शंस, then after elimination reactions, and then the reactions with metals. So out of these three reactions, we are presently concentrated on a nucleophilic substitutions reactions. So what is nucleophilic substitutions reactions? Which type of nucleophiles which attack on your haloalkane compounds? Then number two, what is the mechanism of this SN1 and SN2? What is the stereochemistry portion or optical isomerism? And today we focus about the stereochemical aspect of a nucleophilic substitutions reactions. So in this case, when we studied about the nucleophilic substitutions reactions, as we know that there are always two types of reactions. One is SN2 and remaining is SN1. So first we start with the SN2 reaction. So we have already discussed in our section that in SN2 reactions, right, the attack of for example, if I having a certain type of compound, so in these reactions attack of nucleophile, this is OH minus, which occurs from a direction opposite to the one from the where the halogen atom lives. Okay, fine. So this is the position where halogen is lives, so opposite direction where the attack of OH minus, because we know that OH minus is a very strong nucleophile. First one, this carbon is chiral in nature. Yes, definitely it's a carbyl in nature, because carbon connected with the four different groups, right? C6H13, CH3, Br and H. Four different groups are attached with the carbon. So this carbon is chiral in nature. Now this chiral carbon is attacked by OH minus for the reverse position. First one, it's a primary, secondary or tertiary. So definitely in this case, bromine connected carbon is connected with two carbons, so it's a secondary in nature. So when it OH minus is a strong nucleophile, if we attack, right, so as a result, SN2 reactions of optically active these alkyl halides are always accompanied by the inversions of the configuration, right, of the asymmetric center. For example, if we take a LiO 2 bromo octane, when it is heated with a sodium hydroxide, so 2 octanol is formed, in which OH group, this OH group occupies a positions opposite to what bromine had occupied, right? So it's a total inversion, Walden inversion. So it may be noted that the reactant and the product in most of the SN2 case, except when alkyl iodide is treated with iodide, they are not enantiomers. They are not enantiomers. If we remove iodine and attach iodine, so it's an enantiomer case. But except this iodoalkane, right? Almost, therefore, they are not enantiomers, because it's a different compound to octanol, and this 2-bromo octane is also a different compound. So they, definitely some people says that this is minus plus, so it's a reverse sign, but they are not enantiomer, because it's a different 2-octanol while this is 2-bromo-octane. Now what about the story about the SN1 process regarding, because as we know that the SN1 reaction, if the our alkyl halide is optically active compound, so in this case optically active compound, so carbon is optically active, yes, carbon is optically active, because bromine, ethyl, hydrogen, methyl, four different groups are attached with the carbon, so it's asymmetric in nature. So definitely it's optical active. It's a primary or secondary, so it's a secondary in nature, right? It's a secondary in nature. So in this case, if the alkyl halide is optically active, then the product is the our racemic mixture. SN1 reactions are accompanied by racemizations. This is why, due to the reason that, because in the first step there is a cleavage between this CBr bond, so we get a Br minus. This step one, which can be carried out with the help of protic solvent like water, acetic acid, alcohol. So what's the role of this protic solvent? Due to solvation process, they break the bond, and the energy was required from this solvation energy, right? So now it's converted into carbocation. This carbocation is planar in nature, right? Might well it's a planar in nature. Now this carbocation is planar in nature. So when this carbocation, because now the carbocation is sp2 hybridized, that's why it's a planar species. Therefore, attack of the nucleophile, OH minus is the attack of nucleophile, can occur from both the sides, means front side and back side, or frontal attack or rear attack, right? So we get almost equal, is giving a 50-50 mixture of butene to all in this case. So if one enantiomer, the nucleophile occupies the same position as the originally occupied the halogen, while in other enantiomer the nucleophile occupies a position opposite to that of the halogen. Because in this case the same position bromine, so OH, the same, but in the case reverse it's the second one, right? So that's the point that we have to get a product which is called is a racemic mixture, because it's a 50-50 mixture. So this is the illustrated by a certain hydrolysis of optically active 2-bromobutane, which gives a racemic mixture of butane 2-ol. So it's a very good stereochemical aspect, but mind well, this topic when we have to use, at that time our haloalkane must be chirally in nature. At that time we get different types of optical isomerism that we have to observe. So this is all about the nucleophilic substitutions reactions. Okay, now the most important point. Now we perform such some typical type of questions which is based on these nucleophilic substitution reactions in our textbook, right? In-tax questions, for example, NCERT exercise questions. So first we step by step continue with our, first the point is 10.6, which can be given in your textbook. So what is the question? Because now we start the applied nucleophilic portion of a, because up to 3 or 4 lecture we continue with our journey with a pure concept. Now we have to apply our knowledge to solve this problem. In the following pairs of halogen compounds, which would undergo SN2 reaction faster? Faster, right? So these two compounds, mind well, in this case halogen containing carbon is connected with 1, so it's a primary in nature, but here halogen containing carbon is connected with 2, it's a secondary. Both having a cycle, but they are not aromatic in nature. As we know that SN2 reaction is very much fast in primary compared to the secondary, because in primary there is a less steering hindrance compared to the secondary. So our answer is cyclohexylmethane. Well, in this, okay, fine. Now the number 2 pair is like that. So it's a CH2, 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 CH3. So CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2I. And here same way, CH3, CH2, 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 Cl. So both are primary in nature. Definitely both are primary in nature. So both are very much favored the SN2 reaction. But our question is, which reaction is faster? So this reaction is much more faster because iodine is a very good leaving group due to their greater size. So due to the greater size of the iodine, that's why we this reaction is much faster as compared to the remaining compound. Okay, now our next question, which is based on another point. So predict the order of the reactivity of the following compounds in SN2 reaction and SN1 reaction, SN2 and SN1 reaction. So what they first give? They give the 4 isomeric bromobutane. So first we have to draw the structure of 4 isomeric bromobutane. So first structure is like that, which can be written like that: CH3, CH2, 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 Br. Another structure which can be written like that: CH3, CH. CH3, CH2, Br. Third structure which can be written like that: CH3, CH, Br, CH2, CH3. And last one is the fourth structure which can be illustrated like that. Okay, all are bromobutane. Mind well, they all are bromobutane. This is the 1-bromobutane. This is 1-bromo-2-methylpropane, 2-bromobutane and 2-bromo-2-methylpropane. Okay, so it's the IUPAC nomenclature. But we know that this is primary in nature, same way primary in nature, secondary in nature and tertiary in nature. Why? Because bromine connecting carbon is connected with 1, so it's a primary name. Bromine connected carbon is connected with a 1. So both are primary in nature. But what's the difference that you have to observe in this case? Here, it's a linear structure while it's a branch structure, right? What about this is secondary and tertiary? We know that the ease of SN2 reaction is like that. First, because less steering hindrance, same way. Okay. So, for a tertiary is the last chance because 3-methyl steering hindrance, right? So, it's a cloud of methyl which cannot enter your nucleophile. So, regarding to the SN2, because this is the rate about the SN2 reaction. So, definitely SN1 is the opposite to, fine. So, first is a tertiary, then secondary, then primary, but primary in branch, and this is the primary in linear, because in this case they form a tertiary carbocation. It's a secondary carbocation. Tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation, and secondary carbocation is more stable than primary carbocation. But in this case we observe same primary carbocation, but here the primary carbocation methyl is a donating group, right? Methyl is a donating group, while here this is also an inductive effect that we have to observe. But the in SN1 reactions, we definitely observe the case is like that. CH3 in the case of SN, okay, fine, same way. It's a tertiary is a very good, then secondary, then this is a primary in branch, and this is a primary in layer. So exact is a reverse scenario. So our next concept is it's a point one. Now number two, they give the structure like that. For example, C6H5. So what they give? C6H5, right? CH2Br. C6H5, CH2Br. Next one, C6H5. This is CH3Br. Next one, C6H5, C6H5NBR. And last structure, C6H5C, C6H5, right, CH3NBR. So they give different four types of the structure, and we have to predict the order of the reactivity of this compound in SN1 as well as SN2 reaction. So mind well, all are having aromatic ring, but this is a primary in nature. It's a primary benzylic halide. Bromine containing carbon is connected with 1, so it's a primary. Definitely this bromine connected carbon is connected with 2, so it's a secondary in nature. Same way, it's a secondary in nature, but this one is tertiary in nature. So if we focus about the SN2, mind well, right? So in the case of SN2, your C6H5CH2Br is quite good because less steering hindrance. Next one is like that because both are secondary in nature, but here the crowding effect is quite good due to 2-phenyl ring. But here the crowding effect is low compared to this compound because 1-phenyl ring and remaining is methyl group. Okay, and it's a tertiary is the last one. So the case of SN2, which can be demonstrated like that, this is primary, then secondary and then tertiary. But this secondary having a 1-methyl and 1-phenyl, and here 2. So exactly the reverse of this is connected with the SN1. So first one tertiary, because tertiary is a quite good carbocation. Then we move to the secondary, same way secondary, and last one is primary. But which secondary is prior in nature? Because C6H5CHC6H5, right? So it's a reverse of this SN2 reaction. So this in-text question of example 10.7, okay, under the title of 10.7, they give a two different question, the four isomeric bromobutanes and number two to find out the reactivity order for the SN1 and SN2. Okay, now we move to the another question. Okay, so another question which can be is like that. Identify a chiral and a chiral molecule. Okay, chiral and a chiral molecule in each of the following pairs of compounds. Okay, so strictly I given a your textbook concept, right? Once again, what is the question? Identify chiral or chiral and a chiral molecules in each of the following pairs of compound. So what is the concept behind a chiral and non-chiral? This carbon is chiral in nature or not? Because we know that the asymmetric carbon means the carbon having the tetravalency of the carbon, all four groups or atoms are different in nature. So H is different, CH3 is different, bromine is different, OH is different. So definitely it's a chiral in nature. So we denote it by a aesthetic. But in this pair, two bromine are attached with a single carbon. So both group are same. So it's a non-chiral in nature, right? So this compound is not chiral in nature. Another compound. We know that this carbon is not chiral in nature. This is also not chiral in nature. Same way, because here the carbon is attached with 2 hydrogen. Same way 2 hydrogen, 3 hydrogen. Same way methyl is not a chiral in nature. But this compound is chiral in nature. Yes. Why? Because HOH, methyl and this CH2CH2CH3 propyl all are different in nature. What about this question, right? See CH3CH2C, but mind well, this carbon, okay, first one, second one, this one and this one, not are chiral in nature, but this is chiral in nature. H is different, OH is different, but this is CH2CA3, same with CH2CA3, so CH2CA3 and CH2CA3 both are identical group, so it's not chiral in nature. Next one, CH3, CHBr, CH2CA3, this compound is chiral in nature or not? So definitely this compound is chiral in nature, because this carbon is connected with hydrogen, methyl, bromine and ethyl, so four different groups. But in this case, no carbon is chiral in nature, because this carbon is connected with three same hydrogen, same way two hydrogen, so it's not chiral in nature. So this is all about the our point, our example 10.8. Now we switch over to the another point which is given in your book like that. Okay, so I think so in your textbook exercise of your textbook, they given. Okay, so I think so you in your textbook the exercise which can be given, because at presently we are focusing on an SN2 reaction and SN1 reaction. So which compound in each of the following pairs will react faster in SN2 reactions with the help of OH minus? You know that this both functional group, both group, methyl bromide and methyl iodide, both are haloalkanes, both are primary in nature. But we know that iodine is quite good living group. So regarding to good living group, so the rate of reaction in SN2 in this case is faster compared to the methyl bromide. So your answer is about the methyl iodide. Okay, what about this CH3CCCl or Ca3Cl? Because we know that it's a primary in nature while it's a tertiary in nature. So lots of steric hindrance that we have to observe in the case of tertiary and primary. So in this case, definitely the faster rate of reaction of SN2 in the case of chloromethane. Okay, so this is about the how they react rapidly or what, right? Now we move to the another point is like that. What they given? Arrange the compounds of each set in order of reactivity towards SN2 displacement reaction. SN2 displacement reactions. Once again, arrange the compounds of each set. Okay. So in this point, first we confirm like that. First we draw the structure. So what they given? First one is a 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane. So first we draw the structure 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane. So 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane, which can be okay, this is bromine and CH2-CH3. So it's a 2-bromo. Mind well, it's a tertiary in nature. Then they given a 1-bromo-pentane. So 1-bromo-pentane means CH3-CH2-CH2-CH2-Br. So it's a primary in nature. Same way, CH3-CH-Br-CH2-CH2-CH3. Right? So this compound is secondary in nature. So tertiary, primary, secondary. But we have to focus on what is our question based on? It's based on SN2. So regarding to the SN2, so our primary is quite good compared to the secondary, and secondary compared to the tertiary is our answer. Okay, then another point. So this is all about the 10.16. This question, which is an exercise question of 10.16. Now in 10.16, the number 2 point which can be given, 1-bromo-3-methyl-butane. 1-bromo-3-methyl-butane. So 1-bromo-3-methyl-butane is written like that. Okay, we know that it is a primary in nature. The another question or another structure, the name is like that, 2-bromo-2-methyl. This is 2-bromo-2-methyl-butane. So it's a tertiary in nature. And what about the last one? The CH3 is 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane. 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane. So first we have to draw the structure and we get the idea, right? So what is the rate of the reaction? As we know, that it's a primary, secondary and tertiary. So first primary, then secondary and then tertiary. The same third question is 1-bromo-butane. So 1-bromo-butane is like that, CH3-CH2-CH2-CH2-Br, 1-bromo-butane. Then 1-bromo-2-2-dimethylpropane. So 1-bromo-2-2-dimethylpropane, which can be right like that. Then number 3 is a CH3-CH2-CH3-CH2-Br, because the name is 1-bromo-2-methyl-butane. And fourth one, CH3-CH3, because the name is 1-bromo-3-methyl-butane. Okay, so this compound is primary in nature, definitely. This is primary in nature, yes. This is also primary in nature, yes. And all are primary in nature. So what can do in this option? But here we know that this primary with no branching, there is no branch in this case. Here this primary group, but having a 2-methyl group in a branch. Okay, in this case only one primary, definitely primary in nature, but it's a 1-ethyl group. It's an important question. Well, in this case, 1-methyl group. Okay. Here, this 2-methyl group are attached on a beta carbon. Beta means alpha beta position. Right? In this case, there is ethyl group which can be located at a beta position. While here, in this case, 1-methyl at a gamma position. So what is the rate of the reaction? So we know that 1-bromo-butane is the regarding to the SN2 is quite good. Then 1-bromo-3-methyl-butane, this is 1-bromo-3-methyl, because less steering hindrance in this case. So first, if we write like that, A, B, C, D, okay, so first A, then 1 bromo 3 methyl. This is 1 bromo 3 methyl. So it's a D. Then 1 bromo 2 methyl butane. This is 1 bromo 2 methyl butane. So it's a C. Clear? Fine. And then B. So it's a perfect rate of reactions that we have to observe. Now our next question. Next question is what they given. Okay, C6H5CH2Cl. The question is 10.17 in your textbook. C6H5CH2Cl. Sorry, Cl. And another point is C6H5CHCl and C6H5. So, which is more easily hydrolyzed by aqueous KOH? Which is more hydrolyzed by aqueous KOH? So, in this case, we know that CH2Cl, right? So, if we particularly remove this chlorine, so we get a carbocation. Same way, if we remove this chlorine, we get a carbocation. So, this is a secondary carbocation, while this one is a primary carbocation. This secondary carbocation stabilized by the 2-2 phenyl ring delocalization. Here, in this case, our primary carbocation, this is stabilized by a delocalization over 1 C6H5. So definitely this carbocation is more stable compared to this. So rate of reaction of SN1, because the question which is based on SN1, so it's a readily hydrolyzed by this process. However, if we perform these reactions under SN2 conditions, so the reactivity which is depends on stearic hindrance, therefore under SN2 conditions, C6H5CH2Cl get hydrolyzed more easily. But in this case, SN1, this is more easily. So, this is about the 10.17. Okay. So, various question in your textbook or... So, today's our explanations mainly based on your textbook, and our question is based on a nucleophilic substitutions reactions. In next lecture, we start a very interesting topic, is the eliminations reactions, details of eliminations reactions, and what is the difference between eliminations versus nucleophilic substitutions reactions. Okay, thank you very much.